This program is sponsored by Orient Pest Solutions Private Limited. Pests are smart, we are smarter. Amenia, the taste you love. Nirman Concrete, the complete concrete solution. Co-sponsored by Shimla Biryani, Swad Zindagi Ka. Mix Smart, one-stop shopping solution. Devdas Balcom Restaurant, Al Madina Tours and Travels.
GSS School has felicitated its top 3 rankers of Class 10 examination at its school premises. The felicitation program began with lighting a lamp, followed by speeches of the school authoritarians.
Good afternoon to everybody. I'm speaking from GSS Girls School, Gurbachan Singh Sondhi Girls School, and we are located at 65 Pratap Aditya Road, Calcutta 26. I am Mrs. Nilanjana Chakraborty. I'm a senior teacher of this institution, and we have come here to talk about the great achievers of our institution. They had appeared for the Class 10 AISSE, and we have the top 3 rankers with us. We have Dona Datta, and she has scored 97.4%. We have Anushka Mukherjee with 95.6%, and we have Ramita Duari from with 94.2%. Now, one more thing I would like to add, that our institution, Gurbachan Singh Sondhi, was founded on the 10th of January 1979, and we are 40 years old, and we appear for the Class 10 CBSE or the AISSE examination. Every year we have many proud achievers, and our results are immensely good, and with 100%, 100% result, and many children who have scored above 90%.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dona Datta. I'm from GSS Girls School. We have appeared for the AISSE examination 2018-19. I secured 97.4%. We went to DPS Ruby Park School to give our examination.
Good afternoon. I'm Anushka Mukherjee. I'm from GSS Girls School. I appeared for the AISSE 2019 examination this year, and I secured 95.6%.
Good afternoon, this is Ramita Duari from GSS Girls School. I have appeared AISSE 2019 examination this year, and I have secured 94.2%. Our center was GPS Ruby Park.
How much of time do you devote for your studies?
I have studied for 4 to 5 hours with full concentration, and given me some relief and some free time so that I can relieve myself.
Dona, I would like to ask you, since you are the topper of our institution, that how much of time have you devoted for your studies?
What I believe in is quality matters, not quantity. So I always devoted 6 to 7 hours per day in studying, and with full concentration, and the last 3-4 months I wanted to study with more concentration, solve more and more questions.
What have you done to relieve your tension that was building up in you before the examinations?
I listened to music and I read novels. All this helped me relieve my anxiety just before the examinations.
What about you all? How have you all taken care of to relieve your tensions?
Painting. So in my free time I have done painting to relieve my stress and to get free of anxiety.
What, according to you, is a better method of studying? Is it to, you know, really sit for plenty of hours and cram it and put in some, you know, me time in it and then again go back to it? Or do you feel that if you take a break, it is going to break your concentration? Which, according to you, is a better method of studying?
I think taking break is a better method of studying, because when I'm studying for long hours, sometimes you get overstressed. So it's better to take short breaks in between long hours of study, and in that short break you can recollect what you have studied earlier, jot down the points, and this makes your learning process easier and simpler.
Have you solved any sample papers? And if so, how have you done it? Have you timed yourself? What is the process that you have adopted while writing the answers?
I solved previous year's sample papers, and I set time targets, and I tried to finish them within that time period.
Ramita, have writing answers helped you in any way? I mean, do you think that if you write out, like sometimes, you know, we study something and we feel that we have memorized it and that is enough. Do you think that is really enough, or we need to frame out the answers and write out the answers if we have to score good marks?
scoring good marks, we have to not only just study, we have to frame our answers and write it in a mannered way so that we are prepared with our answers, and this helps us to remember our answers and we don't forget that at our exam time.
What is the significance of timing yourself? Like, you know, you either you set an alarm and then you solve the paper. What is the importance of the time span?
Most of the times during exams, what the problems we face are the time management problem. Most of the times we are out of time and we are unable to complete our papers on time. So while practicing the sample papers, especially before the board exams, where time management plays a very crucial role in securing good marks, time management is very important because that helps you to understand what your writing speed is, and according to it, you can time yourself in writing the answers and you don't face any difficulty in completing your paper on time, and that's the way you fetch good marks.
Did you plan and write your answers in a coherent manner, or do you think it is more important to be spontaneous? Like, I'm talking about a subject like English where your writing skills and your flair is very important. So in such a subject, did you rely basically on spontaneity, or did you frame your answers from before and be prepared for them?
It's better to take 30 minutes right before attempting the question and then planning your answer in a good manner, so that after you don't have to face any difficulty writing your answers. So even if you don't plan your answers and you get an answer incorrect, you have to cut it, you have to cancel it and then rewrite it. So this only causes loss of time.
Ramita, what was the mechanism that you adopted in order to release your tensions? Like, before the exams, you know, you get worked up. So you need a mechanism to release the tension. What was your mechanism?
I studied for 2 hours, then take a short break, and then I do my favorite things which I like, and that I take a few breaks in few minutes and then jot down my points and take a good healthy meal, and I go to bed early so that I don't feel sleepy at the time when study, and during the exam sometimes because of studying for too late at night we feel ill. So I think studying for less hours and remembering it is better, and not to go to sleep at night too late.
Rona, I would like to ask you, what role did our school play?
In my success, my school, GSS Girls School, played a very, very, very crucial role. The teachers, we, the students and the teachers, always shared a very close bond, and whenever we faced any difficulty in writing the answers, in understanding the concept or in determining the content of our answers, we always approached the teachers, and the teachers were very, very affectionate and very approachable. Our respected principal ma'am was also very approachable. We could approach her whenever we faced any difficulty anywhere. Our school also had laboratories, so in case of science experiments, we were able to see those experiments live. So seeing the experiments live helped us to understand the experiments better and remembering it better in a good way. We also have a very good computer lab, so whenever we felt that we need any information on any subject, on any topic, we were able to get access to it. So in this way, school, in my success path, school played a very, very crucial role.
I would like to ask you that who else played an important part in your great achievement?
Definitely our parents. They motivated us outside the school, and also the teachers. We could approach them not only in the class but also outside the class. So
today in our school also, in the physical training has become a very important and integral part of our education, and we had a physical activity period every day. So you were all attuned with the physical activity, where there was a very important part of yoga and meditation also, which was taught in our institution in a very serious manner. So did it, I want to ask you, like, we hear that it does have an impact on your studies. So whatever your physical instructor taught you in our school, did it help you or motivate you? How did yoga help you? Rona, how was yoga an influential factor? Because it has been taught in school that yoga does help. So did it really help you to secure the higher percentage?
In my career, yoga, meditation always helped me. And in my school, every day physical education class was held, and physical education teacher always told us to do meditation and yoga to release your tensions, to feel relaxed and fresh. Because meditation always helps you to concentrate more in your studies, what you have already studied, remembering it in a better way. Yoga plays a very good and very successful role in it. So yoga helped me very much, and meditation also helped me freshen myself after a day's studying. After because before the exams you get too much stressed, your life kind of gets monotonous because all time you tend to study. So meditation and yoga also gives you a break from the monotonous study period, and also makes you feel good and fresh.
What was the way, or what was the method in which you studied a particular subject to get higher marks?
CRT should be treated as the Bible, and in case you think that you need reference, then only you can refer to other reference books, and most importantly, study right from the beginning of the year and follow the teachers. Just before the exam, you can go through the notes that you have collected throughout the year.
What are the tips or the suggestions that you would like to give to the examinees who are going to sit the next year? So you have done it in 2019. There are so many examiners who are going to sit in the 20.
Advise my future examinees that read the textbook first and learn it thoroughly. After that, you can refer to other reference books, and then you will be more cleared about your answers. And you have to listen to your teachers, be attentive in the class, and write all the possible informative points that you got from that particular chapter. And before the exam, you must go through the important points so that you did not miss out anything.
And before we end, I would like to ask you, what are your future plans? What is your target in life, and what are the goals you want to achieve?
My favorite subject is maths and physics, and I want to be a professor in any one of these subjects.
My subject is economics, and I would like to pursue economics, preferably from St. Xavier's.
I want to pursue with science and prepare for joint examination, and want to become a doctor.
From the GSS, from all of us over here, we wish you the very best, and we wish that you can really achieve your success and target. And not only do you become what you want to become, but you become good human beings, good citizens. And our motto of our school is overcome all evil with good. And I would like you to carry it in your hearts eternally and make the name of our school fly high. We will now have our very respected Madam Headmistress, Mrs. Manveen Rajpal, who is the pillar behind the success of GSS Girls School. And now she will share a few words and thoughts as she, being the head of the institution also, she is may help the children to grow up in all spheres and develop their skills and help them to build up a healthy mind and a healthy body.
I am overwhelmed with the results of the students who have appeared in the AISSC in the batch 2018-19. They have done a very good job. They have performed very well. But you know, it is always the wish of any school and every school that all the students should top. Here we have three toppers of our school. And they are Dona Datta, Anushka Mukherjee, and Ramita Duari. We are happy that they have done well, but we expected more from them. They are capable, and they could have achieved a still higher target. They have been trained well. They have been guided well. We've tried to do our best to train them up and to give them all the guidance as far as possible. They also have been enthusiastic learners. They always liked to take extra help. They always came forward for the little extra bit what we always were ready to give them. They have done well, and I wish them all the very best. They are the pillars of GSS, as they have done very well, and I'm happy with the message they have given for the forthcoming batch, that is 2019-20, and I hope the students of coming up in the next session would do more brilliantly and do more better. We are once again proud to have all the three children here, and all the best from my side, and I pray to God that He might help them to attain their goals and they become cultured citizens of this country, carry the name of GSS far and wide in their forthcoming career which they take up. Thank you, and God bless all of you. Thank you so much.